गुड आफ्टरनून सर, थैंक यू सर, टॉप सर।
Om Sushatyam, you are from Bihar.
Yes.
Samastipur. Place of birth, Pusa. Pusa. There is a Pusa Institute in Delhi also. Is it having any connection with that Pusa in Samastipur?
Yes, sir. It has a connection.
And what is that?
Sir, earlier the Pusa Institute was
situated in Bihar. That is from where I belong. An agriculture research institute was established by Lord Curzon. But due to 1934 earthquake, that building got demolished. And then government decided to shift it to Pusa in Delhi.
Okay, so you are from Dayal Singh College, University of Delhi.
Yes.
Dayal Singh. Who was Dayal Singh?
Sir, Dayal Singh Mazithiya was a social reformer and an Indian banker who established Punjab National Bank and the Tribune newspaper. So, and he also established a trust due to which our college is functioning right now.
University of Delhi, what is the logo of University of Delhi?
Sir,
you know logo?
Yes.
Yeah, what is that?
Motto, sir.
Logo. University of Delhi is written.
Yes,
logo.
Sir. Sir, truth, steadfastness, and.
An animal? Any animal?
Sir, I'm unable to recall, sir. I will have to look
at it. Nishtha, that Satyam is written there?
Yes, sir.
This is what it is.
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, related with SDG, you might be very well aware of SDG.
Yes.
Okay, Sustainable Development Goal Index has been prepared as per latest index. Which state is at number one in the Sustainable Development Goal performance?
Sir, it is Kerala.
Kerala. Yeah. Where is Bihar?
Sir, Bihar is at the lowest place.
At the bottom, and just above bottom.
I am not aware, sir. Just
to Jharkhand. Anyway, so why it is at the bottom?
Sir, it is a complex issue and there are multiple reasons.
Okay.
If I dwell into the reason, the first one would be historical. Mm-hmm. Historical, Bihar has been a poor state due to poor governance and low tax revenue. So, it doesn't have much tax revenue to invest in health, education and social sector. Secondly, the priorities of people and the political class there is not very up to mark. I mean, those goals which are mentioned in the SDG, health, education and social sector, they have not been given adequate electoral importance in Bihar. And third would be the low tax revenue presently, because people, due to the intergenerational transmission of poverty, people are not very well placed there. So government does not have very much revenue to invest in these sectors. So that is why Bihar is placed at the lowest level.
Okay, West Champaran district performed very well. There were so many migrant workers who went back to West Champaran, but the district administration took a very effective measure to deal with that very problem, that how can they survive and how can they earn their livelihood. So what exactly did the district administration did there in West Champaran district of Bihar? Any idea?
No, sir, I
don't know. So, Champaran Satyagraha, you might be very well aware of.
Yes, sir.
In which year and what were the reasons?
Sir, Champaran Satyagraha was held in 1917, mm-hmm. and it was against the Teen Gathiya rule of British due to the indigo plantation.
Mm-hmm.
So, in that system, British forced the local cultivators to grow 3/20 of the area for indigo. But indigo did not give much return, as well as they were degrading the soil fertility.
Mm-hmm.
So local cultivators were very angry about this situation. So Mahatma Gandhi came and toured the whole area and then settled the dispute.
In which court that case was heard? In which court that case was heard related with?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware about the court. Okay, thank you.
Okay, no problem. So, there is a state in the country where the government has constituted an economic advisory panel. Can you name which is that state? And that panel is headed by a Nobel laureate. So, which is the state who has constituted that economic advisory panel, and who is heading that panel? And who are the other members of that panel, if you know something.
Sir, the panel is headed by Abhijit Banerjee and Amartya Sen are these members.
Everybody say like Abhijit Banerjee, as well, this is just like that when we say that Panchayatpati. So, Abhijit Banerjee is not heading the panel. You understand Panchayatpati? So, I have asked this question with three persons and everybody says Abhijit Banerjee. Not Abhijit Banerjee, his wife. What is the name of his wife? Who shared Nobel Prize with him along with one more. Three persons shared Nobel Prize in economics. So what is the name of his wife who is actually heading this particular panel? She shared Nobel Prize with him along with one more. Anyway, who else in the panel?
Sir,
very important personality.
Sir, if I am not wrong, then Amartya Sen is also in the panel.
No. RBI.
Then I will have to.
Former RBI governor, who is he? Who?
Raghuram Rajan.
Yeah, that's right. He is one of the members. There are five members in all, including the chairman. So he is also one of them. Anyway, so our relations with Nepal, have they improved during the past few months with the change of Prime Minister there? Who is Prime Minister, by the way, at present?
Sir, I'm unable to recall. Okay, thank you, sir.
Can you recall?
Yes, sir.
But you know that there has been change.
Change in Prime Minister, yes.
In the post of this Prime Minister.
Yes.
You know that.
Yes.
So, how it is going to affect our relations with Nepal?
Sir, India and Nepal is often called a roti beti karista type of relation.
Yeah.
But in the recent times, we have seen the deterioration of relation due to two reasons. The first is the domestic politics of Nepal, where some parties are riding on the tide of anti-India nationalism that is present in some part of Nepal. And the media reports also said that, as ex-Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli said, that Indian virus is more dangerous than Chinese virus. So, due to this shift of the Prime Ministership in the Nepal, we may expect the relation to grow more strong.
Okay, what is Sagar Mission? Sagar Mission.
Sir, Sagar Mission.
Is it an acronym?
Yes, sir.
It stands for?
Security and growth for all in the region.
That's right. Now, you tell me what you know about Sagar Mission.
Sir, Sagar Mission is the initiative of India to have good cordial relation with maritime states, particularly in the Indian Ocean region, such as Seychelles, Mauritius, Sri Lanka, Maldives and all. And India is assuming a role of net security provider in the Indian Ocean region. That is why India has initiated this initiative.
Okay, RTI as such is not a fundamental right, but it is hidden somewhere in fundamental rights. So, which is that fundamental right in which it is hidden?
Sir, it would be Article 19 of...
19.1. No, what exactly that is?
So, freedom of speech and expression.
Freedom of speech and expression. So, how we can say that it is hidden there?
Sir, until and unless we have enough information about...
That's right. So, we cannot express.
Yes, sir.
Or unless we know.
Yes.
So, that's right. Okay. So, our former Chief Justice of India, Justice Babde, while relinquishing the charge as CJI, perhaps on 23rd of April, he said that right to freedom of speech and expression is the most abused fundamental right at present. What's your take on it?
Sir, I would say the whole Article 19, particularly the right to freedom of expression and speech, is bedrock of India's democracy. Because ultimately, unless we have freedom of speech and expression, there would be no democracy and the tolerance. But we have seen in current times that this right has often been abused to incite violence against the government or incite communal feelings. So that might be the context of...
What do you mean by sedition? And when sedition law was introduced in our country? Sedition, and when was it introduced?
Sir, sedition was introduced during colonial times, particularly during the last quarter of 19th century.
1870, no problem, yes.
And it is section 124A of Indian Penal Code, which deals with sedition. And if I talk about the legal term, it means inciting violence or hatred or contempt towards government by any means.
Okay, freedom of speech and expression. In this particular article, an amendment was made, through which amendment in the constitution that amendment was made, and what exactly that amendment was. I can give you a hint.
Sure.
First amendment in the constitution inter alia included this also.
First amendment
inter alia. This was one of the points in that particular amendment. This is the first amendment in the constitution. So 19.2 was added, and what exactly that was?
Sir, it deals with reasonable restrictions.
That's right. Dealt with reasonable restrictions. So reasonable restrictions were imposed.
Yes.
Thank you.
Captain Madhuri, I don't know. Community services. What is actually your role there?
Sir, I did an internship with DAIC, in which my particular role was to lead a team, carry out survey work, attend some conferences or seminar, and then...
What survey you
carried out? Sir, there were various surveys, particularly with respect to how much
people are aware about government schemes, what are their problems and all.
What is your area of the survey?
Sir, my area of survey was a slum in Shastri Nagar. So that was
Bihar.
No, sir, in Delhi only.
Delhi. Okay. Yes. So, what are your findings?
Sir, my findings were multiple. The first, that the awareness about the government schemes among the people were quite low. So we have to work upon that. So secondly,
quite low across the sections. How do you see demographic sections?
Sir, particularly among the women and other marginalized sections, the awareness was low. And second observation was that there is a gap between administration and people. So these two were my primary observation out of
when you say gap, what is the gap indicate?
So the gap indicate the difference between how bureaucracy perceives themselves and how people are working for it.
Yeah, another internship is also about rural development. What is that about?
Sir, I did a rural development internship with DRDA in Ranchi, in which I was assigned at the block level for 2 months, in which I carried out various works such as observing how government schemes are being implemented, how MG Narega, NRLM, SHGs and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan was taking place. And I also engaged in 1 liter of light project, which was presented before Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister.
What was your assessment?
Yes, sir.
What was your assessment?
So the first one was that the government schemes, particularly the Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, was bringing fundamental changes into the life of people in the positive way. So secondly, the Panchayati Raj institutions at the grassroots level, particularly in their tribal areas, are much stronger and democratize the Indian polity. So third one was there was some kind of bureaucratic disconnect between people and the local level officials. So this is what we have to work upon. And one more observation was the strong self.
Why do you say bureaucratic disconnect? It is that disconnect, bureaucrats are responsible?
Sir, there are 2 reasons of this. The first, that I have personally observed that bureaucrats have much higher load upon them because they have to command.
You coined the word bureaucratic disconnect. So why do you say it's a people bureaucrat disconnect? Had you told, I would have kept it. You specifically the bureaucratic disconnect. It gives an indication that the disconnect happens more because of bureaucrats. Should I take it like that?
Sir, there are again 2 reasons of this, sir. It is not only the fault of bureaucrats. Definitely due to the high workload, they may not be able to devote as much time. And secondly, there is also low awareness among the people how to reach to block level or panchayati level.
Is it correct to say bureaucratic disconnect then?
Sorry sir, I will take that statement next.
Okay. So, What is resource curse?
Resource curse. Sir, can I take a guess? Sir, resource curse is a situation when a place have ample resources due to which more people attract towards them. So, this can be said.
Anyway, you can have a check on this Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, all these states are sometimes called the resource cursed states.
Can you explain now? Yes, sir. Sir, they have ample resources in terms of natural resources, rivers, land. They have also high human resources, but they have not been able to utilize those resources. So that is why they.
Can we say after East India Company become British India, British India, we said they have colonized India. What do you mean by colony? Take raw material from one region of the world and supply the finished products. Can we say developed states like Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, etc. are colonizing Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha? Can you say like that?
Sir, I would not use the term the colonizing these areas, but it is due to the historical reasons these areas are backward, and due to these.
Why historical reason these areas are backward? Because Bihar, Patna was the capital of major kingdom, okay, and it was cultural heritage also so very rich. How do you say historical reasons? Where and when the problem started?
Sir, when I say historical reasons, I refer to the colonial times. During that times, the permanent settlement system was most enforced in Bihar and Orisha region, due to which the whole agriculture system got collapsed and there was no investment in either of the sectors. So, that is why I mean by.
Okay. What is the inflation scenario?
In India, inflation scenario? Sir, from the past around 1 year, inflation was rising around 8 to 10%, but yesterday a report came that it has come down between under 6%.
What is inflation targeting?
Sir, inflation targeting is a band selected by Monetary Policy Committee. It is 4% plus minus 2%.
Huh? Plus minus?
2%.
So what happens if it breaches that band?
Sir, if it breaches the band for consecutive 3 quarters, then our Monetary Policy Committee has to give written reasons so why this happened, and then they
will tell some reasons. That's all, no? What is the effect of that giving that reasons? I will give some reason X, Y, Z reasons. That beyond that, anything, any implication is there?
Sir, they will also have to take corrective steps to bring down the inflation. Because
that is, anyhow, they have to maintain that they have to take. Beyond this thing, no impact, right?
Sir, it also gives signal to the market that RBI is working actively to curb the higher inflation.
Video editing, you use proprietary tools or open source?
Sir, I use mainly proprietary tools but borrowed from my friends.
Pirated. Hmm?
Sir, I would not call it pirated. They have access to 2 or 3 computers. One particular software, so I request them to share with me.
Satyam Gandhi.
Yes, sir.
How has the surname affected your life? Positively, negatively? And first name also. And first name also, Satyam Gandhi.
Was it deliberately named so?
Sir, when I was a small kid, I used to be a non-violent and silent kid. So my relatives started to call me Gandhi Baba. And that's why my title became Gandhi.
So how has it affected your life in school, in college?
Sir, in first way, many people assume that I am from the lineage of Mahatma Gandhi, but that is not correct. And in the second way, it has made a huge moral impact on me. The teachings of Mahatma Gandhi, their values, and those things such as compassion, truthfulness. I have always tried to adhere to those principles in my daily life.
Okay. So that has spoiled your life, huh?
Sorry, sir.
That has spoiled your life. You don't have any. You have to live up to that name also, no?
Sir, I think that I am privileged enough that I got this name, so.
Ambedkar's view on caste.
Sorry, sir?
Ambedkar's view on caste.
View on caste. Sir, Dr. Ambedkar viewed caste as a creation of human beings, not as a divine source. And he always talked about annihilating the caste to implement the social equality. He also wrote the book Annihilation of Caste, How Sudras Came and the Caste, in which he said that caste is destroying Hinduism, caste is destroying humanity, and caste is destroying public spirit. So that is what he wrote on caste.
But I see a contradiction here. State government is demanding for a caste census. Is that going to annihilate caste or is that going to strengthen caste?
Sir, political parties may have its own interest when they are demanding caste census. Because if they got to know the true number of how much percentage, how much caste, then they may demand more affirmative actions.
Are you in favor for additional caste census or against?
Sir, I think caste census should be done, but the numbers should not be disclosed for obvious reasons.
So then how? What is the use of having caste census without disclosing the numbers?
Sir, those numbers can be used for implementing social economic schemes by the state and central government. But if we disclose the numbers, then it will have some impacts on electoral point of view.
Now, isn't street photography a violation of privacy?
Sir, that depends upon how we act. For example, if we take the photo and then ask for permission.
So you take the photo first and then ask permission, or you ask permission and then take photo?
Sir, I take photo first then ask for the permission. Because
it's a violation of privacy, so there's no option for the person whose photo is taken.
Sir,
you already have the photo in your phone.
Sir, if the object, I delete the photo. Because if I ask the permission first, then I will miss the frame, which is very important in street photography.
Okay. So how often do you do?
Whenever I feel low or bored, then I take the camera.
And which is your favorite time of the day or location in terms of street photography?
Sir, my favorite time is in the early morning, and my favorite location is Old Delhi, the streets of
Old Delhi.
Yes.
Google has something called as Google Streets. Google Street.
Street.
I told you this.
No, sir. No.
Video editing. What do you do video editing?
Sir, in my college days, I worked as a freelancer for different organizations in which I used to shoot videos for interview purpose or other things, and then I used to edit it and then work for them. So,
what science fiction movies do you watch?
So, I particularly watch movies related to space and aliens and space exploration.
Do you think Indian movie makers don't know how to make science fiction movies?
Sir, they do make science fiction movies, but as compared to the Hollywood ones, they do not qualify.
Would we be able to make a Gravity or a Interstellar?
Sir, in future we may expect, but right now there are two reasons why we cannot make such movies.
What are the two reasons?
Sir, the first one is that it cost a huge amount of money to make these movies, which Indian producers are not well placed in this regard. The second reason, these movies are often watched by urban middle class educated people. But in India, we only love fantasy or action or thriller movies, so they will not be able to recover the amount that they invest in the movies. So
which is your favorite science fiction movie?
So my favorite one is Interstellar.
Interstellar. Can you explain the what you call concept of black hole as portrayed in the movie?
So black hole is a place in a space time where the gravity is infinite, and it is a curvature in a space time, as said by Albert Einstein. And nothing can pass through the black hole, so that is why it is.
So, is there reality in the science that's shown in the movie?
Sir, some part is reality, some part is still fiction, which might become reality in future.
You were also selected in NDA?
Yes,
sir. You didn't join, or what happened?
Sir, I am colorblind, so I was not found medically fit to join the academy.
Has being colorblind any way affected you practically?
Yes, sir. It has certain implications in my life. For example, I cannot distinguish between the different shades of clothes. color of clothes. If I get rashes on the skin, I will not be able to identify where is the rashes. And I cannot identify the traffic lights, green, blue,
which, and red. Which color? Red, green?
Yes, red, green. Huh? Yes.
Surviving for people here. Don't worry too much. I also lost the IPS because of this.
Oh, yes.
You're from Bihar.
Yes.
In North India, they have some stereotypes about people from Bihar. Have you faced any discrimination in Delhi and around you?
No, sir, I have not faced any discrimination as such.
You are not here. What are the popular stereotypes of Bihar against Bihar?
Popular stereotypes? Sir, I do not have any particular stereotypes, but people, some people often say that they are from the labor class or they work for the menial jobs. So, some people only
India
have.
India is doing very good in Hollywood also. For example, many of the designers here are providing services to Hollywood. Are you aware of that?
Designers?
Designing in the sense, stage designing and maybe even your post-production work or even, you know, CGI work. Have you heard of it?
Sorry, sir, I will have to look into that.
What is your opinion on bureaucrats joining politics?
Sir, it depends because if they have good motive, moral motive to join the politics to serve the people, I do not see any wrong in that. But I think there must be some cooling off period after they join.
What is the current cooling off period?
Sir, it is 2 years of cooling period.
I'm sure.
I'm not sure, sir. I will look at it.
Where did you learn street photography after? Did you take any formal course or something?
Sir, from starting, I had an interest in photography. But in college, I joined Film and Photography Society. So that is why I am very much interested in. And I learned the implications of the street photography in the college itself.
Who is a photojournalist?
Photojournalist? So photojournalists are those people who depict journalism through photos. I mean, who depict the real life, what is happening around the world by photos. And they often work for the media houses.
Oh, and you name some famous photojournalists of India?
So, sir, there is one Ravi Chaudhary. He works for PTI. So I know him.
Oh. What is deep fake videos?
So deep fake videos are those videos created by artificial intelligence in which some other people's face is superimposed on original person and the voice is altered using artificial intelligence and the other intricacies. So,
what are the challenges?
So challenges are many. The first, if we create deep, for example, if we create deep fake video of any famous person and then forward it on social media, then it will have mega implications on the internal security of whole India. And second, particularly for the from point of view of women's security, if deep fake video is made of any particular woman, then it will violate their right to privacy and right to life.
Can you name any upcoming science fiction films which is very eagerly awaited?
Upcoming.
Dune, so, have you heard of Dune?
Dune. No, sir, I haven't watched it.
Which science fiction films have you watched recently?
Sir, recently I watched The Martian, Arrival, and Passenger.
The Martian?
Yes.
Arrival?
Yes.
Can you tell me something about Arrival and why is it so special? Why is it critically acclaimed?
Sir, the crux of Arrival movie is that some extraterrestrial species come to Earth, but we do not have any communication with them because we do not know their language. So the organization hire linguistic experts to understand how they communicate with aliens. So this is why it is being said that linguistic and social implications of extraterrestrial life.
Social, oh, and